Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, you have been talked about as a silent performer. What are your comments on it?
Anyway, I don't know who said that, but anyway. I am a performer, no doubt. Right? So, definitely, lot of work has been done for the last 3 years. And there has been a lot of progress in various dimensions. And also, the university is now scaled up to one among the top 10 universities, top 10 state universities, I should say. And that is the reason why we got this RUSA 100 crores. And also, in top 10, we are among the top. So there is a national recognition for the university. Of course, the credit goes to the entire team. We have been working with me. And when I took over, I have set up some agenda, and I have taken up the various initiatives as part of this agenda. And the outcome is there to see now. So probably that's the reason why they are saying that silent performer.
Very good afternoon, sir. To what extent could you accomplish your vision or objectives you had in mind 3 years back?
I would say to large extent. There are few unfinished jobs which I have initiated. Probably those things will be completed in due course. If you want to me, you want me to say all those things. First job done is basically to bring some kind of order, the semblance of, order in academic atmosphere. And I think it will not just like that come up, actually. So it has taken a lot of time for us to bring about that kind of change where this teaching learning process takes place. So I would say at this point of time that now there is, the academic atmosphere, where the students and teachers have realized the importance of academics, and they are now engaged in teaching learning process. That apart, actually, when I took over, the centenary celebrations were also coming up. So we had to work very hard to, celebrate the centenary celebrations in a befitting manner. I think to large extent we have done that task. Apart from that, there was no NAC accreditation that time. We had gone through two cycles of NAC accreditation earlier, and there is a big gap between the second accreditation and third accreditation. And there are a lot of criticism also going on. A number of times we have seen in the press also that, university is not having the accreditation. And because we don't have the accreditation, there was likelihood that we may lose grants also. So we had to work very hard again to put the things in order. It's not easy, actually. You have to perform in various dimensions to get a good grade in NAC accreditation. So, of course, one is the teaching learning process, the research, the infrastructure, and the various amenities and placement. No, everything matters, actually. So we have to create that kind of awareness among the stakeholders of the university. Once again, I should thank the all the stakeholders, the students, scholars, faculty members, and alumni. So they have worked so nicely together, and ultimately we could get the NAAC A plus grade. So having fulfilled that objective, actually, so we started looking forward, and we wanted to bring various reforms in terms of governance, reforms in introducing the technology, reforms in the research. I think we could initiate many digital initiatives also, which has brought the transformation in the system. And it is there to see, actually. I am sure in future, these things will give much more, I would say, effective results in the years to come, because this is the first time actually we have introduced so many digital initiatives now.
Hi, sir. What do you think is the most notable achievement of yours?
The most notable achievement, I would say, getting NAAC A plus grade. So that is going to be there for 7 years. Without that, other things will not happen. Okay. Now, see, there is a recognition at the national level. Right. So I, felt very happy then when they have listed top 10 state universities at the national level, and we are one among them, actually. That's basically based on the NAAC A plus grade. And we also became eligible for Institution of Eminence. And that will get a grant of 1,000 crores. We are still under consideration. In fact, they were telling last time when we met in MHRD, now they have given 100 crores under RUSA 2.0. So they are going to review this in the month of September again. And if our performance is good, we are likely to get that the coveted status of Institution of Eminence. If it comes about, then we'll be getting 1,000 crores. So all this is basically because of our NAAC grade, I would say. This is because, basically NAAC has gained a lot of credibility over a period of time. The grade now matters, for all the grants. MHRD and UGC, they basically look at what is your grade. So based on that only they will consider. But of course, while grade is eligibility, then your proposal is also equally important. So not every university who have this grade has entered into this top 10. So grade and plus the proposal that we have made, both of them have mattered in getting that status. So there is I see lot of bright future for this university. The only thing is we have to work together. Teamwork is very, very important. And using this grant that we got recently, we should make a difference. So particularly they are looking at making these universities the centers of innovations. You know that we don't have that kind of innovation culture where big things emerge from the universities, like US universities. For example, if you say Google has come from Stanford University. Right. Likewise, there are number of innovations that came from these universities. Now that is exactly the reason why not even one university is in the top 100 universities at the global level. Now the MHRD is very keen that some of our universities should figure in the top 100. That will come only when actually we bring that transformation in the universities, where these universities become the centers of innovations. So centers of innovations, I mean to say, there are ideas. So the faculty members, students, they must be having their own, their ideas. And we also do a lot of research here. So we have to take these ideas and research to the next level, where we commercialize these ideas and research. So we have to create that kind of environment where students and teachers and scholars engage, you know, in these ideas and transforming these ideas into, you know, commercial products. So that kind of vibrant culture has to be created in the universities. So this is one of the objectives of the RUSA 2.0 also. So I would say that in a way we are moving towards that. You know, but that, you know, that will not just like that come. But there is an opportunity, I would say, because the top students in the state land in Osmania University. Right? You take any subject, whether it is engineering, whether it is law, whether it is art, social science, science, the cream actually lands in this university. So you have to channelize their, you know, efforts, energies, and then I am very confident, you know, that we can create that kind of environment where this university will become one of the important centers of innovation.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah.
Could you elaborate on the nature of support from the staff, faculty, and the non-teaching staff?
Yeah, I had wonderful support, I should say. For example, so we were preparing for the centenary celebrations. There are times when we worked even after midnight, right? So I could see a number of people working along with me, right, to make that event a grand success. So I would say that that kind of culture already exists here. So it all depends how you take them along. And I would say that, you know, I had the fortune of having so many good faculty members who worked with me, even today now. Even now today, if I say something, they all come to my thing and then they help me. So that kind of, you know, environment exists here.